Hello, I'm Anatoli Mikhailov, and I'm here to talk with you about industrial refrigeration and more specifically about trends within industrial refrigeration. But to start with, let's define a little bit more what we have in mind when we talk about industrial refrigeration. And that for us would typically be large-scale systems, complex systems with capacities of several hundred kilowatts to several megawatts or even more. And there's a project sales. It's a typically large construction systems built on site. We also talk about a wide range of applications, mainly food processing and cold storage, as well as marine, so food-related applications. There are as well some others, such as heat pumps, as well as petrochemical and chemical applications. So, this has been said, this is a very specific industry, however, it's also affected by global trends. And some of this mentioned here, and things like social trends, where we see the food consumption changes, the food consumption increases in number of regions, it definitely affects the way how we chill foods, how we process food. Economical situation, that is also something that affects industry a lot, where the cold stores are built, where food processing is built, and how it's built. Environment. Environment is a big part whenever we talk about energy efficiency or about refrigerants. As well as technology, obviously, industrial refrigeration is a very traditional industry, but technology changes affecting us as well. And we see more and more changes coming in with a very rapid pace. So zooming in a little bit more on the food, and as has been the biggest part of industrial refrigeration. So what do we see here? We see definitely a big increase in food consumption. We see that food demand by 2050 could be increased as much as by 50%. We see also that requirements for high quality food, for good food is increasing as well. And we also see that food production and food storage affects a lot environment. And it's both in terms of production of food, direct emission, as well as a waste of food. What we also see from this graph here, without going too much into details, is that when we go to developing countries, most of the food happens at the storage stage, so during this cold chain process. So it definitely necessitates a demand for larger number of cold stores. Yes. So we talked about some of the traditional applications, but we also see that there are some new applications coming in as well. And those would be things like online retail. And we see a lot of people, especially in some regions like China, for example, ordering a lot of food online. And that necessitates big distribution centers, big distribution cold storages. We also see fish farming is increasing. Most of our fish that we eat nowadays is coming from fish farms, and that's going to be the trend that's just increase. The final application, a relatively new application, is large industrial heat pumps. Again, it's not something that's totally new, but what we see is a rapid increase in some regions of application of heat pumps. So, when we talk a little bit more specifically about industrial refrigeration systems, there are three main components that are affecting them. And that would be safety, energy consumption, and first cost. Typically, I wouldn't rank because depending on where you are in the world, some of the things are more important and some other things are less important. What we can say, however, is on a global scale, safety, that would be one of the most critical parameters affecting the design and use of industrial refrigeration systems. So, when we look at the safety and when we look at the concerns about ammonia, we definitely see that the first people are looking more and more into regulations, and there are not so much new legislation worldwide governing industrial refrigeration systems. However, we see there's a higher need to follow these regulations. And there is definitely a higher need for compliance. And definitely when it happens, systems are getting more safer and better in terms of exploitation. At the same time, we also see the need for reduction of the charge. In the old days, we see that there have been quite a lot of really large-scale systems with huge charges, and depending on how you build your system, how you design the system, you can reduce the charge by a factor 10 or even more. Finally, we also look into other alternative concepts. So basically, if you totally get rid of ammonia, then the system would be totally safe. Probably it's also not entirely true. One of the big alternatives to our ammonia systems, those would be CO2 transcritical systems that we also see are gaining popularity within industrial refrigeration. However, these systems, they have pressures up to 140 bar, and on large systems, they could also be not safe to operate if you do not follow the procedures. So definitely, this is one the big trend that requires a good attention in terms of how you design and how you operate large systems with high pressures. Just to give a couple of examples here, the one would be is a use of a proper equipment and a use of gas detection and safety valves. This is specified by a number of regulations, and definitely high quality equipment would help to build systems safe with this regard. Another example is a change of, for example, evaporators here from bunker coils to air coolers, where you reduce the charge drastically in large cold storage facilities. It could be a factor 10 or a factor 20 even. Moving on to energy efficiency. And well, energy prices, they change a lot, and we can see that the need for energy efficiency has been changing quite a bit. At the same time, if you look at over the time, there's a general increase in the requirements of building energy efficient systems, either driven by the cost or by regulations. And when we look at energy efficiency, there are several ways to address it, starting from selecting the proper system design. Either you would build an ammonia system, or you would build a CO2 system, or it's going to be pump or DX. So there's a different options here. And depending on what kind of options you choose, your energy consumption can change a lot. And that's a decision you take really early in the process. A second option here is looking into the equipment. It's been, as I mentioned earlier about the technology, a lot of changes. So such things as smart components that came in online, things like air purging, this example, and they really improved the energy efficiency of industrial refrigeration systems. And then finally, different concepts. I mentioned earlier about the heat pumps, or combination of refrigeration system and heat pumps can drastically improve energy efficiency of industrial refrigeration. Talking about the heat pumps, and when we talk about industrial refrigeration, that's mainly ammonia, but we also see some other concepts coming in, like CO2, like HFOs with turbo compressors, and that definitely helps the change from fossil fuels to renewable energy sources. So windmills are a great energy source, but if you have a district heating, like we have in Denmark, for example, then they're probably not as great to generate heat. So in this case, heat pump would definitely contribute a lot in building up district heating network. Moving on, the cost consideration. And obviously, whenever we talk about safety, whenever we talk about energy efficiency, everything is connected to the cost one way or another. Either you spend on the equipment initially, or you spend on energy when your system is operating. You can also consider things like maintenance. That's why it's extremely critical when you consider the cost of industrial refrigeration systems that you are just not looking at one element, but you look at the whole process, starting from system design, moving to components, construction, commissioning, and finally to performance and operation of the system. So all the aspects put together driving the cost of industrial refrigeration systems. And I think what we can say in terms of what's happening in the market, to a large degree, contractors look more and more into a whole process rather than a specific element of this process. One of the aspects we've been working on quite a lot, and also supported by new technological development, is creating tools that would support improvement of the design and commissioning of industrial refrigeration systems. The tools like a cool selector, which is not just a selection tool, but especially within our industry, supports the design of industrial refrigeration systems to a high degree, taking engineering work. Rev tools and LLS app, in this case, so it's going to be the tools supporting engineers on site and helping to do a proper maintenance and proper service of industrial refrigeration systems. So to summarize, industrial refrigeration moving on from being a very traditional industry to the industry with a lot of changes, an industry that needs to balance environment affordability and safety, and uses this considerations to create systems that would be sustainable and efficient moving into the future. Thank you for your attention.